tap stuff and Postman stuff and stuff people have never heard of and stuff that they might have heard and didn't know where they knew it from. And so we're bringing an entire evening. I don't know of what yet.
Well, it's music, but it's also, there will actually be a Q&A in the show.
And you're all
you're the one coming along.
Yeah, yeah, and you're going to be coming along on the tour. And so the show has a different shape than what we normally do.
It's, you know, partly it's when you're playing loud rock and roll, which we love to do, partly because when you're doing that, you can't hear the other guys. And you're in your own world. But when you do this, we're really connected musically in a very, in a very different way. The other thing is that we played these characters. We actually did a tour where we did the Folksman opening for Spinal Tap. So we've done that full thing. But we've never gone out as ourselves. And it's interesting, after playing characters on stage all these years, we are having meetings now trying to figure out who the hell
we are. We did actually get a kind of version of an acoustic show as ourselves a couple of times, Museum of Modern Art, and at the Newport Film Festival. So it's really fun.
How did my opinion? Chris, you put out a record yourself recently, like a brother.
I was talking now.
Sorry. Chris Melody.
I'm over here.
Go ahead.
You put a record of your own out recently, right?
I did, actually.
Could you tell us about
it? A record come out about, I guess, a month ago called the Bayman Brothers. And C.J. Vanston and I, with C.J. Vanston is our Spinal Tap keyboard player and producer, and David Nickturn, and we did it's an instrumental record. This is not a funny record, it's just music. Yeah.
Is it like New Agey kind of thing?
No, whoa.
It's old agey.
It's New Agey. No, I don't think it's New Agey. It's, I don't know. It's music.
Okay, all right. Again, the Assembled Press.
Kurt, you're ignoring the two records I put out. They were both Grammy nominated. What is it? Chop Grammy nominated Liberty.
Those are also excellent. I wonder if you might tell us something about
them. No, I wasn't fishing or anything.
I was just observing.
Those are New Age records.
Yeah. Those records would be
New Age comedy.
The Songs of the Bushmen.
Yes.
Songs of the Bushmen.
Michael, have I in any way ignored you in some of your releases?
System. You sit there more than you.
Michael has done musical performances with his wife, Annette O'Toole, at Feinstein's in New York City.
Yes, I've been working largely on the New York stage. When I say largely, I mean I had a big fat suit in one show.
You've got that stage pretty much prepared for me.
So, yes.
Okay, well, we can cover all the individual things. Are there any more questions from the audience?
Will you have a drummer on tour?
No. We couldn't afford the insurance. It's just not worth it.
If you're unplugged, you can't really blow up.
That's right. So. Very good point. So, you find us a drummer.
Okay. I got one.
Yes.
Have you ever thought of writing a completely non-ironic, non-humorous song?
Michael has written a number of completely non-ironic songs. I am incapable of it. I don't know how to do that.
Yeah, I'm with you. Yeah. Oh, you wrote a couple of tunes that are kind of straight.
Really?
Yeah. Wow. Yeah.
He thought they were
ironic. Taking the Red Bird Home? Remember that song? Probably doesn't remember it. No, we'll tell you about it later.
Is Michael publicly available anymore?
My what?
You're not ironic.
No, they're way too straight ahead to go on the market. No,
they're going in his closet, in his drawer. But they're beautiful songs.
You guys mentioned you were in the studio recording the original songs again.
Yes.
When can people look forward to actually being able to buy this album? When will
Wait, is that a good question?
Yeah,
wow.
I think the release date is in May. Is that correct?
May 26th.
May
26th. Harriet Sternberg, ladies and gentlemen.
So it'll be available as CD, download, maybe vinyl?
Maybe vinyl later.
Yeah.
Will there be extra tracks?
Oh, a lot of extra tracks.
I think
a lot of stuff people have never heard.
There are about 7 or 8 extra tracks that no one has ever heard of.
It's like a double.
Not even us.
And when the label's ready to announce that, we'll be more specific.
Right.
But and we'll get you here earlier to the House of Blues with that announcement of that.
With even less hospitality.
Yeah. How many of you are actually drunk? Usually when you have an event like this, kind of at 8, 9 in the evening, we can count on a lot more. But you're actually doing fine. So.
What do you think of Flight of the Conchords' near success? Is that in some ways inspired you to
you
get
mean the guys who beat me for the Grammy last year?
Yeah. Kind of inspired by Tap. I think they're very funny. So I saw them as a club act years ago. I thought they were very, very funny. But it's like parallel universes, I guess.
The three songs that proved to be too difficult to transfer, and you have to go through one.
Well, we've been talking about that. We're trying to figure a way to do Big Bottom on three acoustic guitars. So that is in development, but I'm not sure.
Especially since we played it at Wembley two years ago. We had 19 bass players. 19 bass players. And it's like it's coming down from experience like that.
Including Robert Trujillo.
Yeah, some of them highly competent.
How do you steal a song with 19 bass players?
Yeah,
that's Robert Trujillo,
by the way. So we're looking for a way to do that, and Stonehenge as well.
Stonehenge is problematic.
Yeah, but we'll do it. We'll get around to it.
Otherwise, anyone in the balcony?
No, there's no one in the balcony. Thank you for asking.
Yes,
sure.
Do you guys know what the album will be called, and also what the album art will be?
We're working on that right now.
Right. Yeah. Would you mind sticking around, because if you have any ideas, we can.
Chris's son came up with the best ideas ever. Black cover. It's been done.
Did that, yeah. Black cover with a big white stain on it.
Mm. Mm. You want to explain that?
No. Bleach, Harry, bleach.
Ah,
that's where I was going.
Bleach, Harry. Yes?
Will there be any special effects at all? Anyone
well,
dancing?
What you
anything?
Just saw us do here.
That's pretty much it.
I think
pretty much that jacket, effect. Like that shirt.
No,
that's
no, it's
it.
An acoustic tour. It's a hard premise to get across, but it's basically us acoustically without smoke and trapeze stuff.
No smoke, one mirror, just backstage.
You will not be flying.
No,
we did.
No, it's a non-pony dog show.
No pods.
Huh?
No pods.
No
pods.
No. There will be supernatural beings with
any other questions about the effects?
No, our personalities will be the special effects.
Oh, God, we're in trouble now.
Yeah.
Yes.
Is the troubled economy in any part explainer why you don't have these effects and you see any other way?
It's going to be excuse as any.
Well, we started planning this actually before it really got bad, to be honest. We've been planning this for a couple of years. We started talking about this before it actually went over the cliff. So it was actually really just a premise before it became that.
But it sure helps. You want to tip the hat to the old economy for help.
Anyone in the balcony?
There's no one in the balcony.
Anyone in the back there? Sitting around the bar.
Who actually owns the rights to Spy?